Welcome, I'm your host Aditi Singh and you're watching My India. India is actively addressing climate change by advancing green energy solutions. The country focuses on expanding its solar energy capacity through large-scale solar farms, rooftop installations and new technologies. Now, these efforts aim to reduce dependence on fossil fuels and transition towards sustainable energy sources.
Gujarat, a Western Indian state known for its abundant sunlight, has leveraged this resource to power thousands of homes and businesses. In 2019, the state launched the Solar Energy Rooftop Scheme, Gujarat, to promote renewable energy and reduce carbon emissions. Under this scheme, residents can save on power bills and earn money by selling surplus electricity generated from rooftop solar panels. The system offsets the electricity generated with the household's consumption. Residential consumers can access central financial assistance through the National Portal for Rooftop Solar.
1 kilowatt ke liye 30,000 rupaya, 2 kilowatt ke liye 60,000 aur usse upar 78,000 rupaya ki subsidy भारत सरकार द्वारा पोर्टल के द्वारा डीबीटी के द्वारा सीधे बेनिफिशरीज को दी जाती है और ये बहुत ही अट्रैक्टिव स्कीम है। रिसेंटली माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने जो नई स्कीम अनाउंस की जिसके तहत 1 करोड़ घरों पर सोलर रूफटॉप लगाने का लक्ष्यांक है।
अंडर इट्स रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी पॉलिसी, द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ गुजरात एम्स टू कवर ग्राउंड माउंटेड सोलर, रूफटॉप सोलर, फ्लोटिंग सोलर, canal top solar, wind, rooftop wind, and wind solar hybrid projects. The policy targets achieving 50% of its renewable energy capacity by 2030, with anticipated investments of $60 billion. This initiative has boosted solar panel manufacturers, who are optimistic about the market trends in the renewable energy sector.
इसके लिए सबसे बड़ा श्रेय गवर्नमेंट को जाता है क्योंकि इनिशिएटिव गवर्नमेंट ने पहले लिया था, तो सब्सिडी का प्रमोशनल ऑफर करके गवर्नमेंट ने इंसेंटिव दिया तो लोगों में अवेयरनेस आई। गुजरात जो है ना वो एक व्यापारी स्टेट है, यहाँ पे सब लोगों के खून में व्यापार है, तो उस हिसाब से देखने जाए तो ये सोलर सिस्टम का लाइफ है 25 साल का। 25 साल में उसको अगर सिस्टम में अभी पैसे लगाने से 3 साल में उसको ROI मिल रहा है तो वो सबसे पहले सोचेगा, तो उसके हिसाब से यहाँ पे इनिशिएटिव लोगों ने लेना ज्यादा किया।
Promoting green energy is a key objective for every state in India. States across the nation are making significant efforts to contribute to environmental protection. In Haryana, located in northern India, various initiatives have been undertaken to promote green energy and particularly in rural areas.
Haryana, a state where 80% of the land is used for cultivation, has a significant consumption of electricity. A large number of farmers use water pumps with diesel engines to irrigate their farms. Now, the government is promoting renewable energy and encouraging farmers to adopt solar energy as an alternative source to save money and protect the environment. Vasudev, a farmer in the Rohtak district of Haryana, has installed a solar plant on his farm under the government scheme. He is not only saving money, but also contributing to saving oil and protecting the environment.
खेती में मैंने देखा कि भी जो भी पहले इंजन से हम ट्यूबवेल चलाते थे तो ट्यूबवेल में बहुत ज़्यादा खर्चा बैठता था। इंजन घंटे में 1 लीटर तेल खाता था, लगभग उससे जो है ना मतलब दिन भर में 1,000-1,200 रुपये का खर्चा डेली का होता था। जब से सोलर पैनल सरकार ने दिया है तो किसान के बड़े अच्छी आमदनी बनी है, अच्छा खर्चा घटा है उसका, बहुत ही बढ़िया रहा है।
India is making significant strides in adopting renewable energy with grassroots initiatives, aiming for 500 gigawatts of renewable capacity by 2030. Key efforts include expanding solar and wind power, promoting electric vehicles, and enhancing energy storage solutions. These measures align with India's commitment to reducing carbon emissions and increasing energy security.
Indian athletes are making a mark on the global sports arena, and their performance at the Paris Olympics has been praiseworthy. Today, we take you to India's northern state of Haryana, specifically to the city of Bhiwani. Renowned for its strong boxing tradition, Bhiwani is often referred to as Mini Cuba.
Nupur Shorin comes from a family of athletes, and her role model is her grandfather, Hava Singh, a legendary Indian boxer. Her father, Sanjay Singh, a former international boxer, runs a boxing center named after the legendary Hava Singh in Bhiwani. Nupur, who has represented India at the Asian and World Championships, aspires to represent the country at the Olympics in the future.
First role model to my grandfather, Captain Hava Singh. उन्हीं के बारे में सुनती थी कि वो जैसे उनके जो फ्रेंड्स थे उस टाइम पे और जो उनके साथ थे, जो उनको जानते थे, वो आके बोलते थे कि वो सुपर हैवी में खेलते थे. तो बोलते थे कि उनका फुटवर्क कितना फास्ट था, जैसे लाइट हैवी वेट के बॉक्सर का होता है. तो ये सब सुनती थी मैं. तो फर्स्ट रोल मॉडल तो मेरे फादर ही, ग्रैंड फादर ही हैं. फिर मैरी कॉम, मेरी दीदी हैं, उनका मतलब उनका तो आउटस्टैंडिंग, शी इज़ आउटस्टैंडिंग, स्टिल शी इज़ आउटस्टैंडिंग.
Bhiwani is home to over a dozen boxing academies where budding boxers from both rural and urban areas receive training. These include both private academies and those run by the Sports Authority of India, the APEX National Sports Body of India. To date, around 3,000 national and international level athletes from various sports have emerged from Bhiwani, earning it the title of Sports City.
स्पोर्ट्स अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया का जो है बहुत ही ज़्यादा योगदान है. यहाँ पे उन्होंने अपनी स्कीम खोली हुई है और बच्चे यहाँ रेजिडेंशियल विंग में रहते हैं. उनको उनकी जो डाइट है, खाने का, रहने का और जो उसकी एजुकेशन का, मेडिकल जो फैसिलिटी है और स्पोर्ट्स किट की फैसिलिटी, वो सारा गवर्नमेंट पे करती है.
Bhiwani has produced Vijender Singh, India's first Olympic boxing medalist, who achieved this feat at the 2008 Beijing Olympics. Vijender has been honored with the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award and the Padma Shri, two of India's highest sports honors. Budding boxers draw inspiration from athletes like Vijender Singh, who have brought international acclaim to India.
अभी तक की मेरी जो अचीवमेंट रही है, परफॉर्मेंस रही है, काफी अच्छी रही है और मैंने अभी कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स में गोल्ड मेडल जीता है. वर्ल्ड चैंपियन बनी हूँ मैं 2023 में. तो जब भी कोई टूर्नामेंट खेलती हूँ इस लेवल पे, मैंने कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स फर्स्ट टाइम खेला मैंने और उसमें गोल्ड मेडल जीता, तो काफ़ी एक्सपीरियंस मिला है मुझे अच्छे प्लेयर्स के साथ खेल के. और जो हमारी गवर्नमेंट है वो भी हमें काफ़ी सपोर्ट करती है.
The Indian government's sports policy has been crucial for medal success, with Haryana further supporting India's medal push by offering government jobs and substantial cash rewards to medalists, increasing interest in sports. Of the 117 Indian athletes who participated in the Paris Olympics 2024, Haryana had the highest representation with 24 athletes.
In a tranquil village of Odisha, the shrine of Hazrat Sai Jamal Shah Baba stands as a powerful symbol of spiritual unity and cultural heritage. This sacred site attracts people of all faiths, and the shrine embodies interfaith harmony and brotherhood, creating a community where diversity is cherished and unity thrives. Discover the profound influence of the Sufi saint's legacy on this inclusive and vibrant sanctuary. Take a look.
In the serene and lively landscape of Patra village in Balasore district of Odisha stands a testament to interfaith harmony and brotherhood. The shrine of Hazrat Sayyid Jamal Shah Baba. This spiritual heaven transcends religious boundaries, embodying a vision of unity that resonates deeply with the diverse cultural fabric of India. Hazrat Sayyid Jamal Shah Baba, a revered Sufi saint, dedicated his life to spreading messages of love, peace and unity. His teachings continue to inspire people of all faiths to visit his shrine, which symbolizes communal harmony.
ये बाबा का ऐसा है, ज़्यादातर हिंदू आते हैं, मैक्सिमम 100 में अगर देखा जाए 80% यहाँ हिंदू आते हैं, और ये जो इलाके में बाबा रहते हैं, ये हिंदू 99% हिंदू हैं, 1% मुस्लिम रहते हैं, उसके बावजूद बाबा यहाँ रहते हैं, और हिंदू का ज़्यादा माने मैक्सिमम हिंदू इसको इनका मानते हैं.
One of the most remarkable aspects of the shrine is its role as a melting pot of cultures and religions. The shrine offers solace and spiritual nourishment to all who seek it, regardless of their religious background. Every day, Hindus and Muslims from Patra village and surrounding areas gather here to offer their prayers. This act of collective worship is a powerful demonstration of the shared values that bind these communities together.
हिंदू मुस्लिम पूरा जो भाईचारा है वहाँ देखने मिलता है, और सब विश्वास करते हैं, हिंदू भी विश्वास करते हैं और मुस्लिम भी विश्वास करते हैं. जो हजरत सैयद शाह बाबा जो है, जमाल शाह बाबा जो है, यहाँ जो कोई कुछ मन्नत करता है तो उसका वो उधर पूरा होता है. और मैं भी 5-6 साल से जुड़ा हुआ हूँ, उधर मैं हर साल जाता हूँ, मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है.
One of the most captivating aspects of the shrine is the ritual of tying bricks. This practice is a testament to the deep faith of the devotees. When a person arrives at the shrine with a specific wish or purpose, they bring a brick to the site. This brick is then tied with the shrine's premises as a physical manifestation of their prayer. It represents their hopes and serves as a heartfelt plea to Baba for the fulfillment of their desires. Overall, the shrine welcomes all worshippers, regardless of religious affiliation, to fulfill their wishes, making it a beacon of unity and trust for people from within and outside the district and state.
Now let's delve into World in Focus, featuring the latest global developments and events shaping our world.
Sumaya Al-Baghdadi, a former professor and artist from Basra, is running a pottery workshop for children to help them disengage from mobile phones and social media. She believes that pottery not only fosters creativity, but also allows children to channel their energy constructively. Al-Baghdadi emphasizes a nurturing approach, introducing children to clay and aiming to shift their lifestyle away from screens. A parent, Ahmed Majid, appreciates the workshop as a break from electronic games, noting that hands-on activities like pottery are memorable and teach patience. Educational supervisor Jamila Saleem pointed out the dangers of social media, including addiction, social isolation, and increased aggression. She urged the state to enhance programs that support children and address these issues, particularly emphasizing the need for better management of social media use in Iraq.
Let's explore Madhubani in Bihar, known for its vibrant paintings. From rural mud walls to global art galleries, Madhubani painting tells a story of resilience and empowerment, and thanks to its talented women artists. Join us in discovering this art form, where vivid colors, intricate patterns, and rich symbolism captivate hearts and cross international boundaries.
Music.
Deeply rooted in tradition, Madhubani art has evolved from mud walls to fine paper, capturing mythology, folklore, and daily life. Created by women during festivals with natural dyes, it has now expanded to various mediums, including paper, canvas, and textiles. Internationally acclaimed artists Siobhan Paswan and Shanti Devi, recently honored with the Padma Shri, India's fourth highest civilian award, have dedicated decades to Madhubani art. Shanti Devi's depiction of Chandrayaan 3 received notable praise from Prime Minister Narendra Modi at the 2023 New Delhi G20 Summit's Craft Bazaar.
जो मन में आया बनाते हैं अब वो लोग भी प्रभावित हुए कि हाँ ट्रेडिशनल फोक आर्ट परंपरा कुछ है तो वो लोग भी बढ़ावा और प्रोत्साहन देते हैं विदेशी लोग भी बहुत खुश होते हैं बहुत लोग आते हैं यहाँ और देख देख करके घर अंगना घरे घरे पहले मिट्टी का घर था गोबर मिट्टी सब जाके वो सब लगा कर पूरे घर में था अभी भी रेलवे स्टेशन देखे होंगे आप पूरे है वैसे ही बारपुर में घरे घरे में जाइएगा अंदर में तो होगा।
Today's Madhubani artists preserve the traditional craft while also earning a livelihood, thanks in part to the World Bank-aided Jeevika scheme. The self-help groups formed under Jeevika have given women artists a platform to refine their skills and generate income. This support has not only provided financial independence, but also transformed their lives and brought international recognition to their art.
जीवन में यह भेल है जो पहले अगर रुपया दो रुपया नहीं कमाई छलो हाँ अब कमाई छी से सब लाभ भेल घरों पर कमाई छी तो अब इसी तरह तो कमाई छी तो बेटियों के बढ़िया पढ़ा लिखा रहा छी दुगो बच्चा नहीं पढ़ लखा तीन गो बच्चा तो इमर बढ़िया पढ़ लखा लिख लखा बढ़िया कपड़ा लता रहन सहन खाना पीना सब चीज बढ़िया से करे छी कमाई छी तो करे छी
इसका बहुत महत्व है हम लोग जैसे पहले दीवारों पे जो काम करते थे इसका कुछ महत्व नहीं रहता था इसको पेपर में या साड़ी पे या कुछ पे उतारे हैं जब तब देखते हैं इसका कितना महत्व है जो अभी हमारे देशों में नहीं विदेशों में भी इसका मांग है पूर्ण।
The growing recognition of this art form led to the creation of the Mithila Chitrakala Sansthan, or Mithila Institute of Fine Arts in Madhubani by the Bihar government. As the only institution of its kind in India, it aims to preserve and promote Madhubani art. The institute offers bachelor's degrees and diplomas, employing national awardees, including Padma Award winners, to train future artists.
कहीं पर सिर्फ पेंटिंग के कहीं पर नहीं बने थी जो यहाँ पर हम लोग हैं और बारी बारी लोग आते हैं बड़ी यहाँ हम शिक्षक के रूप में यहाँ लड़की लोग को लड़का लोग को शिक्षा देती हैं
Madhubani painting is not just an art form, but a cultural heritage, a livelihood source, and a symbol of women's empowerment. Its transition from rural walls to international acclaim highlights its enduring appeal. As the world becomes more connected, Madhubani continues to captivate awed onlookers with its vibrant colors, intricate patterns, and rich symbolism.
Indian designers are infusing their culture into international platforms, bringing traditional craftsmanship to a global audience. From Lakme Fashion Week and Haute Couture to India Couture Week 2024, these designers are making lasting impressions with their traditional yet modern approach. Let's explore how Indian fashion is gaining well-deserved international acclaim and attention.
Donned in intricate designs, models walk the ramp, displaying India's artistic prowess as the country hosts India Couture Week. With floral motifs, intricate patterns, and bejeweled and bedazzled embellishments on their creations, Indian fashion designers appeal to audiences through their traditional, fusion, and contemporary approaches. Indian designers are now not only restricted to Indian audiences, but their creations are today translating into Western fashion as well. Amit Agarwal, a renowned fashion designer, showcased his innovative designs that seamlessly blend traditional Indian craftsmanship with contemporary techniques. Agarwal's couture collection, Antivorta, was a profound exploration of time and cosmic influence inspired by the Greek concept of representing the goddess of the future.
I think as a country, we've always been celebrated for the immense amount of craftsmanship and the skill set that we have. But I think at the current juncture, India needs to show a little more than craftsmanship. I think it needs to evolve its language to take it to an international and a global fashion, which may look at craftsmanship as one benchmark to define beauty, but I think ultimately there are multiple arenas of craftsmanship or craft that worldwide is looked at or celebrated as couture.
The world is increasingly focused on India as Indian designers transcend boundaries, bringing traditional craftsmanship to a global audience. According to a report, the Indian fast fashion industry is projected to grow into a massive $50 billion market by the financial year 2031, while the textile industry is expected to expand at a 10% compound annual growth rate, reaching $350 billion by 2030. Paris couture star Rahul Mishra notes that the country's creativity and innovative ideas are drawing the West's attention, positioning India to soon become a hub for luxury retail.
I must tell you, like, even for our stores which are in Delhi, we have got more than 25-30% people who are non-Indians or who are from other origins buying our pieces. So this is really, really amazing altogether, the way they, Indian couturiers are in their choices, the way they go and buy probably a Dior or a Valentino or Oscar de la Renta. So in that way, it is very, very nice.
This is the century of Indian couture and Indian fashion. And, you know, the past century has been in a much more subtle, under the carpet way, as we all know. And I think that this is, this is an opportunity that I would love to see India shining on the global stage in so many aspects. And to be honest, we legitimately come by this badge of being, of our excellence in design and fashion. You know, it's something that's literally embedded in our DNA.
Many renowned actors, including Jacqueline Fernandez, Sonakshi Sinha, Taha Shah Badusha, and Aditya Roy Kapoor, alongside internationally acclaimed designers such as Gaurav Gupta, Jayanti Reddy, and Rahul Mishra, graced the event. Their presence highlighted a golden era for Indian couture, showcasing the brilliance of both the fashion and entertainment industries.
I think Indian couture is right up there right now when we think of international craftsmanship, design, creativity, ideas. I think we're right up there. We have a lot of celebrities, international celebrities right now wearing Indian designers. We have a lot of representation right now in international fashion weeks. And as for the couture week, I think it is right up there. It was very exciting for me to be here because there is this amazing variety and display of the best of the best.
I'm not much of a pink person, but it takes a vision of a lovely designer like Dolly G to put me in something like this, and then when you're in it, you automatically feel really beautiful. So today, pink is my color.
Indian designers are gaining recognition and reshaping global perceptions of Indian fashion. International events like the Met Gala, Lakme Fashion Week, and Paris Haute Couture Week are showcasing Indian fashion and elevating its global prominence.
Indian couture is captivating global audiences, blending traditional craftsmanship with modern innovation, heralding a new era of luxury fashion. With that, it's a wrap on today's episode of My India, but we will see you next week at the same time. Till then, goodbye and take care.